Congratulations, graduates. Being part of your commencement exercises is a great privilege for me as a Sister of Mercy. I feel that in a way, I'm representing all the Sisters of Mercy, living and dead, who created the great tradition in which you, the class of 2020, have been educated and to which you will always belong as Mercy graduates. It has fallen to you to complete your senior year in very challenging circumstances. You've had to forego some of the pageantry and ceremony that you earned and that you have anticipated for a long time. Appreciating that, I found myself wanting to acknowledge somehow in my remarks how special you are. You've passed what amounted to an extra test, a test of your maturity, your perseverance, your good humor. But even as I acknowledge your specialness, I also want to normalize this experience of your high school graduation, peculiar as it may be. After all, you have only this one opportunity to mark a very singular rite of passage, the culmination of what many people believe is the most formative educational experience in your lifetime, your high school years. So yes, the times are unusual, but the meaning of this ritual is timeless. It's meant to celebrate you and to honor as well those who have nurtured your mind and your spirit, parents, grandparents, relatives, teachers, friends, all those whom you love. This is how ritual moments work. They remind us of just how much we owe to others and to the permanent things, gratitude, friendship, the continuity between generations. So even though in 2020 you can't have all the trappings of a traditional Mercy High School graduation, you, like any other graduating class, can and should fix this moment in your minds to capture and commemorate your achievements and your hopes, and to take instruction that it offers you about who you are and who you are becoming. So I urge you, make this graduation of 2020, in all its peculiarity, a sacred memory you carry with you into life. Take a cue from St. Catherine of Siena, who said this: "For the true servant of God, every place is the right place, and every time is the right time." Which reminds me of a favorite saying of another Catherine. You know this one very well because it's been part of your prayer at the beginning of each school day. The signature prayer of Catherine McCauley: "My God, I am yours for time and eternity." To belong to God for time is to love the world as God loves it, to care about redeeming the world and all who dwell in it. To belong to God for time is to be astonished at the nearness of God in our lives, even here, even now. But we also pray to belong to God for eternity. This is what enables us to live in the present as people who believe in a future full of justice and joy, a future that we as people of faith can help to bring about. To belong to God for time and eternity is the prayer of all the Sisters of Mercy for you. God bless you, graduates of 2020.